Please welcome Dr. Uematsu.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm truly grateful for this opportunity to speak to you today. The title of my presentation is Optimal Timing for Implant Placement in the Aesthetic Zone. Before going into my presentation, I would like to briefly introduce myself. I'm a member of the largest dental study group in Japan, called SJCD, which stands for the Society of Japan Clinical Dentistry. Our dental study group consists of 12 branches, and we have about 1,500 members made up of dental technicians, hygienists, and dentists. And we also have a group called SJCD International. The president of SJCD International is Dr. Masao Yamazaki, who is a pioneer of aesthetic dentistry in Japan. First of all, I represent anatomical limitations and biologic problems in the aesthetic zone. In this diagram, you can see the facial bone thickness is only about 0.63 millimeters, which number is average for a Japanese person. Therefore, alveolar ridge resorption normally occurs following a tooth extraction. I would like to represent a paradigm shift in implant therapy. The original concept is we have to have enough bone around the implant about over 1 millimeter. The occlusal force has to be on the long axis of the implant. In the paradigm shift, recently we have used an implant for anterior area, which is generally thin bone volume at the labial side. If we don't have enough bone, we use GBR procedures and add the bone. And if we don't have enough soft tissue, we must add the soft tissue for proper aesthetics. The occlusal force is not on the long axis of the implant. As you can see, there are different inclinations at the alveolar process. For example, in the aesthetic zone, from a central incisor to a first premolar, there is a large discrepancy between the proposed angle of the fixture of the alveolar process. Recently, we have used implant in the anterior area. In some cases, we have had aesthetic problems with the interdental papilla and gingival levels.